Today I am going to teach you how to stage and how to manage acute renal failure. Now you know how to diagnose acute renal failure. 50% rising of serum creatinine or 50% reduction of your renal function within past 7 days, you can say your patient having acute renal failure. Rising of serum creatinine from its baseline value, how much? 0.3 mg per deciliter for the past 48 hours. Past 2 days, you can see your patient having acute renal failure. Dropping of urine output less than 0.5 milliliter per kilogram per hour for 12 hours, you can see your patient having acute renal failure. Now you know how to diagnose. There are three methods. One thing is rising of serum creatinine or dropping renal function 50% within 7 days. Number two, rising of serum creatinine 0.3 mg per deciliter for 48 hours, within 48 hours. Number 3, dropping urine output less than 0.5 milliliter per kilogram per hour for 12 hours. Last week I found 2 patients. One patient urine output just less than 5 milliliter per kilogram per hour 12 hours. Other patient anuria for 12 hours, no urine at all for 12 hours. What do you think? Both patients are same or different? Different. Again, I found a patient with rising of serum creatinine 0.3 mg per deciliter for the last 48 hours patient. Another patient I found rising of serum creatinine not 0.3, 3 mg per deciliter for last 48 hours. Both are same or different? Even though they have acute renal failure, their degree of renal destruction, degree of renal damage is different. Then we need some kind of renal failure staging. Then you have to think about the disease severity. Then you have to think about how aggressive you should treat your patient. For that, you need some kind of staging. Currently, practice staging is belong to kidney disease improving global outcome criteria. What? Kidney disease improving global outcome. KDIGO criteria. Kidney disease improving global outcome. Called KDIGO. According to KDIGO criteria, they give 3 stages of acute renal failure. You have to find out which stages is belong to your patient. They use urine output criteria and serum creatinine criteria. Urine output criteria and serum creatinine criteria. They label as stage 1. They label as stage 1 if urine output less than 0.5 milliliter per kilogram per hour for 6 to 12 hours. If you found a patient with urine output less than 0.5 milliliter per kilogram per hour for 6 to 12 hours, you can label as your patient having acute renal failure. Or acute renal failure stage 1. When coming to serum creatinine criteria, 1.5 to 2 times elevation of baseline serum creatinine or 0.3 mg per deciliter rising of serum creatinine from baseline value, this is your patient having stage 1 acute renal failure. Now you can see, even though they increase serum creatinine and urine, dropping urine output, you can put either here or somewhere here and down. Now we are going to move into the stage 2. They label stage 2 as, if you found a patient with less than urine output 0.5 milliliter per kilogram per hour, more than 12 hours, you can label it. Your patient is in stage 2 according to KDIGO. KDIGO means kidney disease improving global outcome. This is stage 2. Then when coming to serum creatinine, 2 to 3 times elevation of serum creatinine from its baseline value, you can say your patient having acute renal failure according to KDIGO stage 2. 2 to 3 elevation from baseline. When coming to stage 3, you can label Your patient having stage 3 renal failure. Once your patient drop urine output less than 0.3 milliliter per kilogram per hour for 24 hours. If you calculate 24 hours urine output, if it is less than 0.3 milliliter per kilogram per hour, you can say your patient having stage 3 renal failure according to kidney disease improving global outcome criteria. Or anuria for 12 hours. In my previous example, I found two patients. One, just marginal urine output less than 0.5 ml per kilogram per hour, 12 hours. That patient also having acute renal failure. Next patient, what I found is anuria for 12 hours. That patient also having acute renal failure. But previous patient was belong to stage 1. Second patient was belong to stage 3 renal failure. When coming to serum creatinine criteria, elevation of serum creatinine level more than 3 times from baseline value, you can say your patient having acute renal failure. Or if you don't know about the baseline value, but you found very high serum creatinine with acutely deteriorating patient, how much? More than 4 mg per deciliter serum creatinine, very high amount of serum creatinine. Until proven otherwise, until you exclude chronic renal failure, you can manage this patient having acute renal failure. Or if your patient need renal replacement therapy, that means dialysis or hemofiltration or diafiltration, whatever the thing, if your patient need, that patient is belong to stage 3. I will revise again. If you found a patient with urine output less than 0.5 ml per kilogram per hour post 6 to 12 hours, that patient must be belong to stage 1 according to KDIGO. Serum creatinine 1.5 to 2 times from the baseline value, or elevation of serum creatinine more than 0.3 mg per deciliter from its baseline value, again that patient is belong to stage 1. Stage 2, urine output less than 0.5 milliliter per kilogram per hour more than 12 hours. Or elevation of serum creatinine 2 to 3 times from baseline value. When from stage 3, dropping of urine output less than 0.3 milliliter per kilogram per hour for 24 hours or anuria for 12 hours. Belong to stage 3, and when coming to serum creatinine criteria, elevation of serum creatinine 3 times from baseline value. Oh, more than 4 mg per deciliter serum creatinine, isolated finding. Oh, patient need renal replacement therapy, is belong to stage 3 of KDIGO criteria. There are other staging criteria used previously. Luckily, you no need to remember those things. Now they are not that much practice. This is the most recent one and currently practice. But sometime in the exam they ask, most senior consultants going to ask from you, what are those criteria? Better to keep mind, just name is enough. One criteria is rifle criteria. Rifle criteria. Risk, injury, failure, loss, end stage. Rifle mean. Risk, injury, failure, loss, and end stage. Criteria. Rifle criteria. Other one is Akin criteria, acute kidney injury network criteria. Those are also used urine output and serum creatinine most of the time, but lack of time factors and other factors lead into removing of those two criteria. Thanks God, otherwise you have to keep in your mind that as well. If you found a patient with acute renal failure, you diagnose it there, you stage, what is remaining? Management of acute renal failure. Now you know how to diagnose and how to differentiate it from pre-renal, intrinsic renal and post-renal cause. Post-renal cause is very easy. You just want to do an ultrasound scan and exclude obstruction, put catheter and see the obstruction. If there is obstruction, it must be belong to obstructive type or post-renal type renal failure. If there is no obstruction, other two remain, intrinsic or pre-renal cause. Now I am going to manage patient with acute renal failure. Even though your patient have pre or post renal or intrinsic renal failure. Post renal failure, you can just relieve by putting catheter or relieving the obstruction. If your patient having intrinsic or pre-renal failure, you have to manage fluid status of your patient. You have to maintain the blood pressure. You have to ensure about adequate renal perfusion. Management of acute renal failure. Number one, check whether your patient having adequate fluid status. If not, you have to resuscitate fluid. Check your patient having adequate blood pressure. Check whether your patient having adequate blood pressure. Adequate volume state you need to perfuse your kidneys. Per minute, 1 liter of blood should go through your kidneys. Adequate blood pressure is need to filtrate the glomerular filtration fraction. So you should have adequate fluid status and adequate blood pressure. Next one, if you are a patient on nephrotoxin, you have to stop. If you are a patient on nephrotoxin, you have to stop. Stop nephrotoxin. It may be contrast nephrotoxic drug like aminoglycoside. What are the other drugs? Metformin and ACE inhibitors, you have to stop. You have to stop nephrotoxic drug. If your patient having sepsis, you have to treat. Why? Sepsis itself can cause intrinsic renal damage. Treat sepsis. If you found a patient with raised intra-abdominal pressure, you have to stop further rising of intra-abdominal pressure. You have to reduce intra-abdominal pressure. How are you going to reduce intra-abdominal pressure? You can insert NG tube and decompress your stomach. You can insert rectal tube and decompress. Sometimes you may have to open your abdomen in order to decompress. Sometimes paralysis and ventilation can help to reduce intra-abdominal pressure. If you found high intra-abdominal pressure, it may precipitate your renal failure or it may be cause of your renal failure. Then you have to treat it. Next one, ensure adequate glycemic level. Why? Your nephrons are now suffering. You have to give adequate amount of glucose. Ensure normal glycemia. Next one, not only normal glycemia, you have to ensure adequate amount of hemoglobin is there. Why? Hemoglobin is the one carries oxygen to your nephrons, mainly medullary part of nephron. That is the most vulnerable part of ischemia. So you have to maintain adequate hemoglobin level. Next one, the last one. If you found a patient with deterioration of renal function in spite of all those things, you may have to consider a renal replacement therapy. Either peritoneal dialysis or hemodialysis or hemofiltration. You have to consider renal replacement therapy. I will repeat it again rapidly for you. If you found a patient with acute renal failure, even though cause may be different one, but you have to prevent further damage. In that case, you have to optimize the fluid status. So you have to optimize the fluid status. Check whether your patient having adequate amount of fluid in their circulation, IVC collapsibility, SVC distensibility, or other way around. Left ventricle outflow time velocity index. You have to check whether your patient having adequate amount of fluid in their vascular volume. If not, you have to resuscitate with fluid. Number two, maintain adequate blood pressure. You may have to use inotropes or vasopressor in order to maintain the blood pressure. Next one, stop all the nephrotoxin. If you are using contrast to diagnose, sometime you have to manage, you have to resuscitate fluid prior to giving contrast. If you want to give contrast, space out it as much as possible. today and not today and tomorrow, today and day after tomorrow. Likewise, space out of the contrast, then it will allow time to recover your renal function. Then if you are patient on nephrotoxic drugs like aminoglycoside, gentamicin, metformin or ACE inhibitors, angiotensin converting enzyme inhibitors, you have to stop those drugs. If you found a patient with sepsis, sepsis itself can damage the nephrons. You have to treat, you have to give antibiotic. Burn and pancreatitis also can cause acute tubular necrosis. So you have to manage those conditions according to that. Then you have to reduce intra-abdominal pressure if you found you have high intra-abdominal pressure. High intra-abdominal pressure means how much? Pressure more than 12 mm mercury. Normal pressure 5 to 7. If it is more than 25, you have to vigorously treat. Why? Your patient can develop abdominal compartment syndrome. Kidneys are suffering in that case. You have to relieve it. You may have to paralyze the anterior. You may have to insert catheter or NG. You may have to insert rectal tube. You may have to open the abdomen and relieve the pressure sometime. Next one, ensure normal glycemia. Hypoglycemia going to suffer your nephrons. Nephron blood supply is limited now. On top of that, if your patient has become hypoglycemic, nephron start to die. It is not a good thing. Your renal failure can precipitate. Ensure normal glycemia. Ensure adequate hemoglobin level of your patient. Last one, consider renal replacement therapy, not late early. That is all regarding early renal replacement therapy go to improve your patient outcome. That is all regarding the management of acute renal failure. Thank you very much.